from the perspective of the Russian president, he's viewing Ukraine through the lens of World War II, right? He sees it through the lens of the Great Patriotic War. So, you know, I think that his objective is to destroy Ukraine. He wanted legal recognition of Crimea. He wanted a denazification. And then he wanted neutrality, right? Those were his three objectives going into the peace talks. And, you know, you can't really believe that those are the real objectives because, first of all, he already de facto controls Crimea, right? He doesn't really need to ask for that. Second of all, the denazification efforts have been extremely robust on the part of the Ukrainian government, right? Anybody who voiced a slightly neo-Nazi political program in that right after the Ukrainian Revolution of 23-2014, those people have been disabled, brought to justice, put in prison, silenced, right? So that whole like far, you know, radical right element in Ukraine is very much under control, right? It's not really a topic of concern right now. And then finally, this whole neutrality thing, you know, that too, you have to question because Ukraine's entry into NATO was not on the table. Ukraine's entry into the European Union was not on the table, right? So what is this about? This is about destroying a country whose values and beliefs are at odds with those of the Russian government, right? Namely, this tradition of freedom and democracy, right, is very threatening to Russia because that's not what Russia is today is about.